Hello, anybody, somebody, nobody, whoever may never see this. This is Siegfried Alexander Faust, the Lift. Coming back at you with some more Warhammer 40K. This will be Gene Stealers 1.5. I fervently believe this is a better list than what I just showcased. I'm going to be uploading both videos. And this is also kind of a silly list. I really like it. So, this got soupaged. And I'm gonna be going through this in detail. I'm not gonna show off every single model because there's Lord knows how many, and it's gonna take me a hot minute anyway. And again, this will be uploaded and in the next like day or two, I'll probably be refreshing all of the lists in my Google Drive if anybody wants to grab them, and this will be there. Okay, so Gene Stealer Cult. This has Broodbrother, Guardsmen, and Tyranids. Because of changes made, I can bring Tyranids, but then I don't get the improved to hit crap with Brood Brothers and my Tyran and my Gene Stealers. I'm not gonna be using them though, so I don't think I care. I can still bring my Gene Stealers are still gonna get their benefit, which is gonna be Twisted Helix, and then the Tyranids are going to lose their benefit, but I can take one adaptation. They just lose their adaptive, base adaptive, and so I'm going to swap out their other thing via Hyper to Lurk to give them something for Psychic. And then the Brood Brothers just have what they have. But I have a company commander here and a tank commander to hopefully do some stuff. Okay. So, I don't even know where to begin. Brood Brothers. Infantry models and Brood Brothers detachments increase their leadership characteristic by one and gain the unquestioning loyalty ability. I was debating trying to switch the list out to get another tank commander in here. Or, technically, you could run. Change it up a lot and run three tank commanders. But since I'm forced to take the Brood Brothers detachment, I versus Cadian, Catachan, or Accustomed to improve the tank commanders. I think I'd rather just bring Exocrines instead. And this kind of worked out pretty well with the points, so I'm happy with this. Unquestioning loyalty. So everyone, all of these guys, they get plus one to their leadership. Hooray. Unquestioning loyalty. Each time a Twisted Helix character model, I have only two. Every time a saving throw is failed, then I can select one other Twisted Helix or Brood Brothers model with this ability. So they're gonna get all that crap. And then they take a unquestioned loyalty test. To do so, I roll a d6, adding one to the result if the character model is Patriarch, which it is. So on a three up, let me just hover over this. On a three up, the test is passed, and my patriarch won't take any wounds. Instead, the friendly model I selected is destroyed, and the attack sequence ends. So basically, I can just have conscripts just huddle around the patriarch, and they'll just soak wounds. They'll do what the old Iron Hands used to do with their dreadnought. You can do that with them, and they're a bunch of bodies. Furthermore, what I'll be doing is I'll use, because of the guard shit that came out, I'll have the company commander give them all of their las guns to rapid fire two, and then I'll make it so they reroll hits of one, and then what'll happen is any sixes become of the new rules become auto wounds. So hey ho hey ho. Because Hammer of the Emperor is for regiment, which is nutty. And then the tank commander is gonna just have Meltas on it. It's gonna have a. This one's not correct. It's gonna have an auger. Oh, wait, no, it is. An auger array, hunter killer as well, demolisher. The Tyranids, they're gonna be from Gorgon, which will give them access to a stratagem, but honestly, It doesn't really matter. They could be from almost anywhere. I just want them to get the lurk for Synaptic Aghelia. So I can reroll a Deny the Witch test taken from units with adaptation. So free reroll the Deny the Witch test, and I have four different Psyker units. And then each time a psychic power manifested by units adaptation, increase the range by 3 inches. So that means I get to have 21-inch smites instead. And you know, these just pump out mortal wounds. I could bring Malaceptors instead of the Exocrines. That is definitely an option to consider. Or I could bring one instead of an Exocrine, but I feel like the Exocrine does more. The Malaceptor. Actually, it's gonna be you. Pull this up real quick because you can have them do diffusion auras instead. But they're not getting the defense bonuses. You know what? I think the Exocrines are barely better because my Jormungandr fleet of Tyranids has Malaceptors, but that's giving them dents as well and the other benefits. They're psychic. This is not the case because you're not going to be able to give the extra plus one to psychic because of the Neurothrope. That's something else you're going to lose because it's souped. And your Gene Stealers, you don't get the crosshair rule. Oh no, it doesn't matter. It would work with Guard. So that's something I would have been able to do, but then I can't bring any of my Tyranids. I'd have to bring a bunch more. How much? This is perfectly 500. Yeah, I'd have to bring an extra 500 worth of Gene Stealers and no Tyranids. And you know, that's an option, but I feel like just the amount of freaky mortal wounds I could pump out with these Zoans is gonna be better. That list is gonna have few CP, and the thing is your tank commander already has a hit on a 3-up, so this is something to consider. I just, and the conscripts, their ballistics is gonna be ass. You're not really relying on them to do damage. Versus the Zoans are gonna get that mortals, them juicy mortals. I don't know. And then, because even if you got the crosshair and you change the list to make it work, right? Phone keeps going off. Then you have to actually still set it up. You have to set it up so they'll actually get the crosshair and they'll get exposed. And then this is all for one tank commander who could just get blown up anyway. So I feel like this is superior. That is tempting, but it is, you know. It's the evil temptation. Don't give in. Don't listen to it. So yeah, this is gonna be their psychic smites will probably go off because I'll just do boom, boom, boom. So that's gonna be on a 5, a 6, and a 7, or a 5, 6, 7, 8, and then they're gonna get plus 3 to their shit anyway. And then for 3 flat mortals additional, so it's gonna be 4, 8, 12 mortal wounds on something, all kinds of stuff. Exocrines, which are just great for every Tyranid army now. And then the Pure Strain Gene Stealers. These have 4 attacks each. So combined, that's 120 attacks. And because of Twisted Helix, they're going to get plus 1 to their strength and plus 1 to move. And then wound rolls of 1s and 2s, so 2s, fail against them. Yeah. And basically, you just run the Patriarch up. You have these as your backliners. So you have 3 potential backliners. These are your middle liners. And you just charge up the freaking field. And it has really good damage output. And these guys can be hidden as well. They can be ambushed. You still have your ambush. So that'll be really good. Ugh. And the Patriarch, because you can't have Warlord Trait relics on Tank Commander, and you can't take Tank Ace. If I could take Tank Ace, oh my god. But unfortunately, you cannot because Even the thing for Tank Ace. Hold on. It cannot, it specifically says without the Brood Brothers keyword. And then you could also do it if you have a warlord that is them. But again, it's not Brood Brothers, and you can't have your warlord be Brood Brothers, so it does not matter. Cannot take 10 Ks. Patriarch. So, oh my god, there's so much on him. My Patriarch is going to have Psychic Familiar. He's going to have Psychic Stimulus, Might from Beyond. For psychic powers, he's going to also have the Immunogenic Deviation, Twisted Helix. He's going to have the Relic of Elixir Prime Specimen. And because I have a Biophagus, I get to get two choices. And he's going to have Bioalchemist for the extra damage. So he's going to be doing, not on sixes, because on sixes he gets even stronger. Six attacks, strength 5. AP minus 4 for flat 3 each on 2 ups. And then on 6s, it's AP minus 7. Suck it, Custodes. Or I should say, like, suck it. I don't know. You'd have to find a Space Marine with a 2 up save and no invul. Because that'd be Armor Dominus on Heavy Cover. Armor Dominus would make it AP 6. Heavy Cover would make it AP 5. Yeah, and then that would bring it to it doesn't have a save. I don't even know if that situation exists, but here you go. And then damage 4. But nonetheless, it's gonna bring Death Guard Terminators to their invul, and then each one will be a dead Death Guard Terminator. But it will be 4 ups to wound them, unfortunately. However, since he has the other things, he's gonna get a plus 1 to his attack, and he can fall back and charge. So, cool things, all cool things. Let's see. And yeah, this stuff doesn't really matter. The Neurothrope is going to have Catalyst and the Horror. The Zones, I just gave them all Psychic Scream in case a new situation comes up. And then they're just going to have the High Fleet Power along with Smite. Company Commander, regular Plasma Pistol. And then he's going to again be doing extra shots to the Laz Guns and reroll hits to get them sixes. Yeah, this is just a really wonky list. But I still feel like it's superior to the other Gene Steel list. I already got rid of it. Does it mean it'll win? I don't fucking know. But like, it's got one of the best things from Guard, some of the best things from Tyranids, and some of the best things from Gene Stealers. And the fact that you can run this as a legal match play list, I think is very entertaining. It's very funny to me. And I don't think it's to be underestimated. I feel secure saying that. It can get swamped and bodied, but it definitely has the potential to do likewise to your opponent. My God. I just think it's hilarious that your Broodlord will just be, like, invincible as long as you have conscripts. And because these are troops, these have OPSEC. Actually, I don't think they'll get OPSEC, because. You know, yeah, they do. They don't lose it just because they're brood. So yeah, all of the conscripts also have OPSEC. And like, what's your opponent gonna do? Just focus the conscripts down, leave everything else alive? That works just fine. So yeah, this should be really nutty list. I guess I'd recommend this. I already spent a lot of time on this video. This is going to be the last one, I believe, for the Xeno series, covering individual armies, exception for the squats for when they come out, as long as they are not Imperium, which I don't believe they will be, but I could be wrong. Yeah. And then for any questions, complaints, compliments, advice, recommendations, requests, feel free to shoot me a message in the comments, etc. Or just comment the video, like, share, subscribe, all that nonsense. I do appreciate it, I guess. It did make my morning to talk to some people about some questions they had and talk about the Harlequins a bit. And again, you can check for any updated lists, and you can expect when more information comes out. I'll be making the Knights list for Imperium and Chaos very shortly. I'm very excited for a lot of the Chaos lists that I'm going to be editing. Oh. Yeah. Oh, and then I don't believe you can Yellow Scribe. These aren't fully Yellow Scribe because right now, Mal Sector's zones and some stuff, I think, are having trouble. They're not coded yet between BTS and Yellow. But yeah, this is a tournament legal list you can play in match play because these are Brood Brothers and these share the Tyranid keyword. So you can bring them in and you still keep your Twisted Helix. You just lose Crosshair. This doesn't get its benefit and this becomes Brood Brother. It's all regiment. Without further ado, I hope you all have a great day and take care.